Drainage improvement project on the Anselm Coulee in Youngsville will move forward. The dispute between Youngsville and LCG is now over. As we first reported 2 weeks ago, LCG pulled the project from bid after Youngsville Mayor Ken Ritter wouldn't agree to the terms.
Now, LCG wanted the city of Youngsville to take responsibility for all future maintenance of the Coulee, but Ritter challenged that notion. And as Danielle Garcia reports, LCG has agreed.
That's, you know, what we're put in office to do, is to make the phone calls, to admit when we're wrong.
Mayor President Joel Robideau and Youngsville Mayor Ken Ritter signed a contract on Wednesday, allowing the drainage improvement projects in the parish to move forward.
Today's a great day that that the mayor, president, and the city of Youngsville have come to an agreement on the scope of the work and the parties that are responsible for the work.
Ritter initially challenged LCG, calling it a bait-and-switch tactic.
And the reality is that he called into question some language that he felt put more burden on the city of Youngsville than the current law places on the city of Youngsville. And so when I looked at it, I tended to agree with him, and he was gracious not to say I told you so.
Through some open dialogue, we have resolved those differences. It's been our position that it is the parish responsibility for drainage that's prescribed by state law. There's also LCG ordinances that relate to that fact.
Mayor Ritter says he is happy his initial concerns were heard and are now resolved.
Drainage knows no political boundaries, and I think what our constituents expect is for us to work together on these type of issues.
In Youngsville, Danielle Garcia, KTC TV3.
Mayor President Robideau also mentioned today all the drainage projects that ranked top priority should be out for bid by January, and he anticipates roughly $2 million left over to continue some of the other projects ranked after that priority list. Stay